Hello, this video is going to walk you through assignment 3 for Computer Science 340. The goal of this assignment is to use hash tables to do a simple form of sentiment analysis. Now, sentiment analysis is a sort of form of natural language processing where you read in some text in English or another human language, and you decide if the tone of the text is more positive or more negative or sort of neutral in between. Now, there's lots of sort of advanced sort of research in doing this well, but we're going to do a very, very simple form of it where we just read in all of the words from the text and look them up to see if they are more positive words or more negative words. Now, in order to do that, you're going to build a hash table and populate it with words read in from a sort of sentiment file. And so the keys for this hash table are going to be the words themselves, and the values are going to be the sentiment, which is a integer between -5, which means really negative, and +5, which means really positive. So like if you look up the word, you know, horrible, it would give you a sentiment of maybe -4. And if you look up the word amazing, it would give you a sentiment of maybe +5. So that's what your hash table is doing. So to do this, you're going to need to create the hash table, load in all of the words, and then read in user input. For each word you read, you basically look up in the hash table and see if it has a value or not. If it doesn't, you'll assume it's a neutral word. But if it does, you add that sentiment that it gives you into sort of a running total. And then at the end, you sort of print statistics. What's the total sentiment? How many words did you read? And what is the average sentiment of each word in the input text? So let's go ahead and take a look at that. All right, so first off, I want to emphasize again that this is a pretty simple form of sentiment analysis. There's a lot of fancier things we could do, but we're going to keep it simple. For example, if we found like a movie review that said, this movie is not bad, we would actually, the way we're doing it, give it a negative rating because we would just see the word bad and that would have a negative sentiment associated with it. We're not going to do things like invert the not there to realize that's actually a positive or at least neutral sentence. But for our purposes, it's going to work pretty well. So like I said in the beginning, you are going to be using a hash table to do this, and we're going to load the hash table with the contents of this file called sentiments.txt. And the thing on the left here, the word, is the key in the hash table. And the thing on the right, the sentiment value, is going to be, of course, the value. So we're going to load all of this into a hash table so that when you see a word, you can look it up using the word text itself, the key, and get the associated sentiment with it. So like you see, the numbers are negative for negative connotation words like abhorrent. Abhorrent is not a positive word. That's a bad thing, a bad adjective. And so that gets you a value of -3. Whereas let's scroll down for a more positive word. Okay. Admiring here is +3. And so you can see that there's just thousands and thousands of words in this file with the more negative words having negative values with them and more positive words having positive values with them. One other thing about this file is that there are a couple of multi-word phrases. Like if I scroll down here, there's a couple with spaces in them. So we have cool stuff is a multiple word phrase that has a value of 3, whereas cover up has a value of -3. So there's a few of these like multi-word phrases in this file as well. And those will be important because when you're doing the part where you read in user input, you're going to have to check kind of like two words consecutively as well. There's no longer phrases than two words. So you only have to worry about single words being matched and also two words sequentially with a space between them being matched. So there's two main parts of this assignment. The first part is going to be improving the hash table implementation that we have. And the second part is going to be doing the actual sentiment analysis. So with our hash table, the way that we coded it and described it in class, we create an array of a fixed size, and then we load the words into that array using the hash function to figure out which index they go in. But we didn't have any way to expand the table and make it bigger once it reaches a certain size. So the first thing you'll do in this assignment is making it so that the table automatically expands when it becomes too big. Remember that for a hash table, it shouldn't be totally full for sure. And it also shouldn't really even be almost full because as it becomes, you know, over halfway filled, then there's going to be more and more collisions as it gets closer to being full up. So what you're going to do is you're going to detect when the table is half full, and then you're going to double the size of it. So if you started off with size 100, you'll fill it up, and then once it hits 50, you'll double it to size 200. And then if it gets to 100, you'll double it to size 400. And so that will ensure that the table stays between a quarter to half full, but doesn't ever go more than that. Now, unfortunately, it's a little bit more complicated than it was for like an array when we needed to double it, because we can't just increase the size and then carry on where we were. So to see why, imagine we have this hash table, which we set up with size of 10, and which now is storing 5 items in it. So now we're going to decide to double the size of it. Well, the simple way to do it would be to do it just like this. We go ahead and make a new array of double the size, and then just copy the existing array into the beginning of the new array. But that's not going to work because of the way that we do the hash index calculation. For example, when we hashed A and put it into slot 3 originally, it could have been that we actually got the index 13 out of our hash function, but because 13 would have fallen off the edge of our array, we then modulused it by 10 in order to get 3 and stuck it into slot 3. So then when we had an array of just size 10, we would always look for it in slot 3. But now if we keep A in slot 3, then what's going to happen is, because now our size is 20, when we get the 13 as the hash value for A, we're going to modulus it by 20 instead, which just gives us 13. So then we're going to come down here to slot 13 looking for A, and it's not going to be there. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to double the size of the array like this, but then we're going to have to rehash all of the items that were in the original array. So we're going to loop through this array and find an item like B, and then put B's key back through the hash function, and then modulus it by the new size of 20 instead to figure out where it goes in the new array. Maybe it'll go in the same place, but some of them won't. So if we get the E here, maybe E is now going to be moved into the second half of the array, and A, I think we said, would go in slot 13. Maybe C stayed in the same spot and D went down here instead. So you have to rehash the items that were in the existing array, skipping over the blank spots, of course. You don't want to rehash these because there's nothing actually there. So the steps here in part one will explain how to do this resizing process. You're going to start with the hash table we developed in class. Currently, that class doesn't have any way to keep track of how many things are actually in the hash table. It just creates the initial size to be the capacity of the table, but you'll need to add a size variable to keep track of how many things are actually in the table. In the constructor, you should set that up to be 0, and then you should increment it each time the insert method is called, so you're keeping track of how many items have been added. Then at the top of the insert method, you should check if the number of items currently in the table is more than half of the max size. So if you detect that the table is halfway full or more, then you should expand the table. And to do that, I'd suggest making a new method and not putting it all inside of insert. Make a method called expand. You can make that a private method because no one else needs to call it except for insert. And inside of that method, what you're going to do is basically what we talked about here on the board. You're going to make a new array for storing your keys, and you'll also make a new array for storing your values. Remember, there's actually two separate arrays going on. So make those two arrays to be twice what they were. Then loop through the existing table, and for each item that you find, use the key that you get from the keys table to calculate a new index, remembering to use the doubled size, don't use the original size. Then take the value and the key and stick them into the new expanded twice as big table that you got. Then at the end of that method, you'll have to reassign the tables. So like here, if this is our keys table, it starts off referring to this array, you're going to have to re-refer it to the new array you made, which is twice as big. So that's the first part of the assignment, is doing the hash table so that it can be expanded. The second part is doing the actual sentiment analysis. And so to do that, what you'll do is you'll make a hash table object from the hash table class that you just improved. This hash table is going to be mapping strings to integers. So your strings are the keys, those are the words, and the integers are your values. Those are the sentiment values, the plus 3 or minus 3 or whatever. And in order to make sure that your expanding code works, set it to a small size like 50, so that way it'll have to expand multiple times in order to be big enough to hold all the data. Then you should load the contents of the sentiments.txt file into your hash table. So you'll read in all of these lines and insert them, of course, with the first thing being the key and the second thing being the value. You can assume that the file will be called sentiments.txt and it'll be in the same directory, so you don't have to ask the user for the file name or get it on the command line parameter or anything like that. Then finally, what you're going to do after you've loaded the hash table is actually get the user input from the keyboard and look up all of the words that are put in. So for the user input, you'll keep reading until the user types in the word end. So as an example, you can see they have text, several words on the same line, and then it can continue to the next line. That's all fine. You just have to stop when you see the word end by itself like this. In order to improve this a little bit, there's a few things we're going to do to the user input. The first thing we're going to do is to make all of the words you read lowercase. That way, if the user types in like bad with a capital B, it'll still match it with the word bad that you find in the file. Likewise, you're going to remove all punctuation from the words that you read. So for instance, that will allow tasty comma to be matched because it doesn't have a comma, obviously, in the sentiments file, it's just tasty. So you should do that. Likewise, incredible here with a period after it, that will remove that as well so that incredible can be matched. You'll also have to check for the two-word phrases. And so, for instance, I think in the second example, no sense is in there as a two-word phrase, because no by itself isn't necessarily a good or bad word. I mean, I guess it could be bad, but not necessarily. And also sense is a neutral word, but together no sense is in there with a negative value. So to do that, what you can do is, as you're reading through the input, keep track of the word you're on, but also the previous word as well. So you can check the word you're on, then you can also check the combination of the previous word and the next word and see if that's in there. For every word you find or two-word phrase that is in the file, you should get the associated sentiment value for it and keep track of a running total. So when you first start off at 0, then if you see a positive 2-word, you add to positive 2. Then if you see a negative 3-word in there, you subtract to get to negative 1 overall. And so you keep a running total of like how much sentiment have you seen so far. Then at the end, you should print how many words you've seen, what the total sentiment value is, and then the overall average, which would just be 31 divided by 19 here. You should print the average to two decimal places, so 0.61 in this case. We have an example of a positive thing, which is a positive sentiment, and then a negative thing as well. For your general requirements, like usual, don't use global variables. Keep stuff private when you can. Make sure your code is reasonably well commented and reasonably well indented and so on. And then when you're done, send me the code on Canvas by submitting it. If you have any questions about this assignment, please just send me an email or a message and let me know and we can talk about it. Thanks.